Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, B-books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame. From France, astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2. They're a politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get, and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh!
Hi, my name is Barry Miller. I'm a trustee on the Woodstock Library Board. Recently, I attended a conference in Tarrytown, New York, for trustees from all over New York State. A lot of the discussions going on during the day had to do with the fact that libraries are not just books anymore, that libraries need to incorporate more technology into their systems to keep up with the times. Dr. Renee Hobbs, from the Harrington School of Communications in Rhode Island, gave a presentation, and during her presentation she showed a video clip from a library in Auburn, Maine, and it's about their digital media lab. I requested to obtain that video to show you for this TV show, so I'm going to show it to you now, and I hope that you all enjoy it. Thank you.
Local library normally means a quiet place to read a book, but a library in Maine is thinking beyond that.
It has opened up a state-of-the-art digital media lab, the first one in a New England public library. Our Marnie McLean has the story.
A pretty guitar or an electric guitar?
Electric.
A trip to the library has gone a lot more exciting for 4-year-old Joshua DeForest. The library in Auburn, Maine recently opened a digital media lab, the first one in a New England public library. With grants and donations of $20,000, the library bought computers, microphones, keyboards, cameras, lights, and software for music and movies.
We want people to be able to create content as well as come to the library and use the content that's here.
For the cost of a library card, you can learn how to edit photos and publish them to the web. Music fans can play with GarageBand and have an orchestra of instruments at their fingertips.
It gives kids something to do that they love to do that's not really affordable at home.
You can even make your own movies. The lab has an HD video camera, a green screen, shoot anything you want, put it into a computer, edit it, use special effects, then post it to YouTube, and you've made a movie at the library. Jim Wilkins says it's not just kids and teens. Older people are using the lab, making photo albums and transferring VHS videos to digital media.
It's absolutely critical that libraries keep up with what people want and how they want to use their information and how they want to interface with their information, because that relationship is obviously, it's changing.
Local businesses are also excited about the lab. They can make web videos or create original music without making a capital investment or paying big money to an outside company to deliver content.
So having the opportunity to come in here to utilize this, it starts to level out the playing field with a lot of larger communities.
There's always going to be books at the library, but in order to stay relevant, the Auburn Library felt it needed to offer something more.
And libraries have to do that, otherwise they're just going to disappear.
In Auburn, Maine, Marnie McLean, NECN.
Hi, I'm Michael Hunt, the president of the Friends of the Woodstock Library in beautiful Woodstock, New York, and I just want to take this opportunity to talk to you about the 83rd annual Woodstock Library Fair. We had such a fantastic fair last year celebrating our centennial that we just want to repeat that again, especially the sunshine. Here's hoping we have the sunshine. But last year we had a children's parade that came down across Tinker Street and into the fair, and then we had a maypole dance with all the kids dressed up in their costumes. And we were talking about it, we loved it so much, we're going to do it again. The kids are asking for it, we still have the maypole. So that's how we're going to start the fair again. And last year we also had a, we brought back the clothing sale, the thrift sale. And it was really successful because we got to remember that for us it's a fundraiser as well as a big party for the town. So this year we're having the thrift sale again. Men's, women's, and children's clothes this year. And also the collectibles we brought back in the same tent with the clothes. And that was really, really successful. So we're bringing that back as well. Some of the other things we are bringing back, the Yum Yum truck. We have all the delicious food, all cooked by volunteers, hamburgers and hot dogs and lots of summer fare. All donated by people, restaurants in town, cooked by volunteers. We also have the Yum Yum food truck coming back for a little different flavor. And they're bringing back their wine and beer garden as well, so you can be walking around with a drink in your hand, enjoying the beautiful sunshine. The raffle this year is really wild. We're going to have all the usual prizes from every business in town. But the grand prize this year is a magical Woodstock weekend. Two nights at the Aunt Dora Mountain House for two, dinner at the Bear for two, a private yoga class for two, Dave Holden Nature Walk for two, and another restaurant. So you get two restaurants, Aunt Dora Mountain House for two nights, and these great activities. And second prize is going to be a mountain bike from Overlook Mountain Bikes. So look for raffles all over town, and of course you can buy them at the fair. The music, we got a great lineup. It's going to be really great. We thought of the passing of Pete Seeger and his connections to Woodstock, so we're going to start things up after the Maypole with a tribute to Pete Seeger. Nancy Chusid, this wonderful music teacher and musician, she's affiliated with Phoenicia International, the International Festival of the Voice, and Maverick Concert Hall. So she's organizing a tribute to Pete Seeger. We're getting our dance floor back we had last year, which was so much fun, just seeing kids and grown-ups dancing the afternoon away. So after the tribute to Pete, we're having a Dave Leonard dance party. Hopefully we'll get all the kids and grown-ups out on the floor. And after that, we got the Dharma Bums are coming back after a couple years. The Cupcakes are going to play. Paul Green Rock Academy kids are going to do a little set. And Lindsay Webster Band, they're going to play later in the afternoon. And then Jay Collins of the Greg Allman Band, of the Lee Von Helm Band, the Midnight Ramble. He's got an upstate band called Jay Collins and the Four Notes, and he's going to close out the afternoon on our stage. And somewhere in the middle of all that great music, we're going to do a little tribute to our two honorees. This year, we're going to honor Barbara O'Brien, Lee Von Helm's manager, and a longtime native Woodstocker. And we're going to honor Barbara this year, and also Michael Lang will be our other honoree, very close to the 45th anniversary of the Woodstock Festival. So we are really looking forward to a great fair. It's a great day for the town of Woodstock. It's a great day for the library to celebrate all our love for the library. And we hope you come out and celebrate. We had a really nice crowd last year, and we had the beautiful sunshine. And also, there are many things to do. Everyone, from the volunteers to the cooks to the people at the gate taking the gate money, they're all volunteers everywhere along. People doing the clothing, people setting up, people taking everything down, cleaning up. If you would like to participate in any way as a volunteer, please check out woodstock.org, call up the library, we'll get in touch with you, and we can figure out a way for you to participate more than just being a spectator at the fair. And we really appreciate all the support we get. Thanks so much.
Hi, I'm Martin Nystrom, live on McDaniel Road, been here for 35 or so years. I'm an architect. My specialty has been daycare centers over the last 15 or 20 years. I've done about 75, all in New York City. Living in a house that we built starting in 78, and continuing to build and spend money on every year. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. We've lived in the city for an awful long time, and 5 years ago, we sold our apartment and are now full-time residents. But I certainly feel that I've been here many, many years. Originally brought up in New Paltz, and then back to New York for my career. I use the library pretty regularly. My wife, Sandra, uses it very regularly. I love it for research. As I get interested in a subject, and my main subject or my main interests, book-wise, are historical novels and the flow of history. So if I'm interested in who was that guy Garibaldi, I'll get a book out on Garibaldi, something I don't want to buy. Now I quite often buy books because I'm a habitually slow reader and I'm too embarrassed to renew and renew and renew. So I quite often buy books that I can keep in my library. But if it's a thing like a Garibaldi that I'm not going to need, I'll borrow it and return it at whenever. My draftsman is Turkish. I picked up an interest in Turkey after having interest in Spain and in Italy, but most recently it's been in Turkey. So I went to the library and I got a book on Ataturk. Who is that guy Ataturk? George Washington of Turkey. Well, found it very interesting, and I find the whole subject of Turkey very interesting, so I proceeded then to buy all the Pamuk books and read half a dozen or so of Orhan Pamuk books, which give you a flow and a feel for what history is, you know, at least in Turkey. It's led to other books on Turkey. My most recent one, the one I just finished, is by a person by the name of Tenapar, who wrote The Time Regulation Institute. And this is a discussion of clocks and their relationship to the modernization of Turkey and how it came to be. And they form a governmental institution to regulate everyone's watches, and you pay money to have your watch updated, and you pay fines if you don't have the right time. So quite interesting, and that led through cocktail conversation with someone who had not read the book to give me this latest book, Birds Without Wings by Luis de Benares, pardon my French. I like books that push me a bit. I've read books recently and some pretty bestsellers, like I read this one here, Unbroken, Laura Hildebrand, which was on the bestseller list, but in my mind quite lightly written. Historical, but quite lightly written. A book that pushes me like this will have statements in it to give me some thought, such as, man is a bird without wings, Islander told them, and a bird is a man without sorrows. So that gives you something to think about after you've read it. The way I'll read a book is I read it at night, get up in the morning and read again for an hour or so, and then go about my day. But my style of reading is such that I have to be immersed. I can't put it down. I can't read it on a subway. I have low retention, so I really have to push on a book to get it done. So this is my latest one. That's that book. I highly, highly recommend it. I'm only about halfway through it, but thoroughly enjoying it. The Improbable Journey of Henry Fry was another little gig on the side that I've read. Went to Venice, studied the history of Venice. Go to Spain, travel through Spain. Another own book, The Disinherited by Cayman, which is the story of the artists and in all arts that are thrown out of Spain at various periods of Spain's history, and how they, Picasso included, how they become so creative but outside of their original cities and environment, their original country. So I like historical novels. I like to understand the flow of history. With regard to the library, I find the library fairs to be incredible for me. I'll go, I can buy a book for a quarter, I'll read it. Last year I bought a book for a quarter, I got 100 pages through it, and with my retention ability, I found out, damn it, I already read this book. So I turned it back into the library. So I bought my own book. I think the library fair is very, very important in so many ways, not just to provide me with books, but for the community to come together as a whole. So Friends of the Library, I think, is an incredibly important function of this town. And I applaud those people that are active in it. For me, the library, I think, we could all say, is the center of a town, of any town. It's the center of any school. The library is the most important individual heart of every town in this country. And so too the town square and all the other parts like the rescue squad, the fire department, the police department, the municipal government, all of those important parts. But the library is the one place that we all ages come to, of all abilities come to, and everyone gets something out of it. So I support the library. I support in its endeavors, and I thank you for your time. With regard to technology, I am amazed at the curve that is happening. Within my field, architecture, it is going so quickly that we really can't keep up. I think with pencil. I find that the computer can do so much beyond my abilities. It still takes my pencil to start, but the computer will do so much more than I can ever do and help me think. As I look at the library and I see the computerization at the entrance and the usage and the needs of the people that are patrons, it really makes me realize how important and what an increasing need this is and how it will continue to advance beyond whatever we have now. And I'm quite happy to be this age. And I laugh at my son and I tell him, you think I'm having trouble with technology? Just wait till the trouble you have in 30 years from now. Because we don't even know what it's going to be. And the book stacks, will the book stacks be there? Probably. But will they be used more? No, they'll be used less. I read from an iPad now. I read my morning newspaper every single morning from an iPad. It doesn't give me the same level of satisfaction, but that's only because it's me. And because of my age. But I think the future of the library, of course, will be in technology. I designed a library for the Cathedral School, St. John the Divine, back in the 90s. And at that time, it was a learning center. And you could do a lot of things, but it was not what a technology or center would be today. It is not what a library would be today. Things are moving much more quickly than we can possibly imagine.
Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter, Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, B-books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame from France. Astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2, there are politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get, and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh.